Steve, can you tell us the latest on Larry Ekundayo?
Yeah, Larry Ekundayo is going to be fighting Dale Evans on the 14th
of March. What happened to Denton Vassell?
Well, Denton Vassell, it's quite strange. We thought the deal was done. We had the deal with Tommy Gilmore. We gave him more money than he'd ever get off on an off-TV show.
Mm.
Tommy accepted the fight in principle. It was all, we thought the deal was done.
Yeah.
And then Denton Vassell changed his mind.
Personally,
through his manager, Tommy. Then
that would have been a seriously good fight. You got a former ABA champion against the most talented fighter in the world, and with less than 10 pro fights.
Exactly.
That no one.
But I think Denton Vassell knew that as well. And to be honest, it looks like he just bottled it. Because the fight was done, the money was issued.
His demands were almost ridiculous.
The point was, at the end of the day, the deal was done with his manager, and his manager's a very smart man, Tommy Gilmore, who's been in the business a long time, and he felt what we were offering financially was really good.
Yeah.
And then to Vassell then just said no.
Vassell, coming off two losses, needs to, I mean, where else is...
Well, I didn't really understand where Denton was going. I thought it was a good fight to match. It gave Denton a chance to put himself back on the track, gave Larry a good opponent. And if Denton is going to go back to the top level, he'd need to beat Larry Ekundayo.
How frustrating is it for Larry, do you think, to have one prize fighter, weight division above his, pardon the pun, natural weight, to then be sort of frozen out of them?
Well, all I can say is I've only looked after Larry for 6 months.
Mm.
He's not been frozen out since I've looked after him.
From a sporting perspective, in terms of fights, say Frankie Gavin, Skeets, guys like that, above him on the box check rankings.
Well, he's in the Who Needs Him club, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's too dangerous. He offers little reward for him at the moment. He doesn't have a title. This should change.
He has huge potential in Nigeria.
Yeah.
In terms of, I know his commercial manager's got big. I mean, he's always talking to the. He could be a Nigerian ambassador,
You can see, he's Ben Gray, who looks after him, does a fantastic job. He's brilliant, Ben Gray, and he's been fantastic for Larry. But in terms of boxing in Britain, Larry doesn't offer anything other than risk to these other fighters.
Absolutely,
that's why we have to secure final eliminator status or titles for him.
Do you know who I would try and secure? I'd try and secure John Fashanu to come to the fight, and you make him a bigger face within the British Nigerian community.
That sounds a great idea.
And that's like, I don't know if you saw Tommy Martin against Boyland.
Yes.
Okay. And so, he brought in, questions I know the answer to. Danny Dyer came
that's
in,
right?
And I read up on it. I said, how did that work? I don't know. I'm friendly with Tommy, but do you know why he came in? Because Tommy, who's only 20, used to babysit for him.
Is that true?
How cool is that?
That's great.
Now people always slag off the ticket sellers coming up. And yes, but what give them props that they use all... Yes, he's a good-looking kid, but there's work and innovation that comes with that as well. So perhaps John Fashanu or...
Yeah.
I'm not that clued up on football now. And Achebe. I'm thinking of there are a few Nigerian footballers who've done well here.
That sounds a really good idea.
And if you bring it and you make him... big within his community, as big as possible, then
hopefully the doors will open. I think we've got the doors open now. I mean, if he wins his fight against Dale Evans, he'll be in line then to fight one of the titles.
All of the economic fundamentals are split, like that you said about the Who Needs Him club, he offers nothing but risk. Where the sanctioning bodies are there to pick up fees, right? In my opinion, not yours. I don't know, but those economic fundamentals will be there. You can still pull out. As you've seen, the guy just vacated because he didn't want to beat a guy who'd humiliate him.
Absolutely. But what we need with Larry was I've had him for two fights.
Mm.
And we haven't, with all due respect to who we've beaten, we've beaten nobodies.
Mm.
So consequently, we now need Larry to beat somebodies so that we can start getting ranked in these.
Have a look at Junior Witter.
Yeah.
Maybe Junior Witter gives you a huge name.
We offer Junior Witter. We contacted Junior Witter for
add 50%
of it. Sorry?
Add 50% of it, you'll take it.
Junior Witter didn't even come back when we suggested the fight.
It's a legacy name, though.
Yeah, but he didn't come back. We contacted Junior Witter and asked him if he was still fighting. We suggested what he had. No reply.
Fair enough, but he's still got balls to pay. I know that.
I mean, when Vassell pulled out, we went for the two potential options were Witter and Dale Evans.
Mm.
Witter still waiting a response from Dale Evans. Took the fight, and we want to get the fight on in March, so we don't have time to be hanging about.
How is Larry's daughter?
She's had the surgery the other week, and I saw Larry, and they're just hopeful that they've got it. So we just got to keep
it. Okay, so it's not conclusive either way. So, but you're happy with him to get into camp and to take the fight?
Well, his trainer Harry Andrews is the man in charge. He makes those decisions.
Okay.
and Harry is happy with him to do it. I think it's a big burden for him to take this fight with his personal situation, but that's going to be a situation for Larry. Larry wants to do it. Harry Andrews believes he can do it. He's 32 years of age, and so it's his time that he must do it, I guess. So he's doing it for his daughter, so it's going to be an emotional night for him, and let's hope he prevails.
Okay, and we'd invite all of his personal training clients and everyone in the Nigerian community as well to come to the fight.
Yeah.
Including my girlfriend actually trains with him. She's been demanding tickets off me.
I mean, this is actually Larry's really real first defining fight since in quite a few years, and he needs to win this fight. If he wins it, he moves on. If he loses, it's possibly the end of the road for him. I don't think he will either. So we wouldn't have made the fight if we thought he would lose. We think he wins, and we think this is going to be the start of something very big.
Don't forget Witter though, down the track, because he's got bills to pay. That's all I'm saying. Eh?
Well, Witter can have it.
I spoke with Witter, and he was talking about some. I don't know what he was talking about, but he was so mad. And I was like, well, okay, you're still fighting, you Frank. Yeah, you're a name still, but on someone's legacy in terms of...
Well, the fight's over. Hopefully, when Larry beats Dale Evans, Junior Whittaker is more than welcome to come along in June or July.
And then you can... So then Larry will show more balls than Ricky Hatton did.
Yeah, exactly.
In his career, right?
Larry will fight anybody. The thing about Larry Ekundayo, he is a true warrior. He doesn't even care who we match him with. Yeah. He just says he will fight absolutely anyone. We don't have to vet opponents. We just tell him who he's fighting.
Yeah.
He's a fantastic ambassador for boxing. He's a true warrior. And people like Junior Whittaker can come and have a go if they like. Larry Ekundayo, this is going to be his defining year. And we hope by the end of the year, we are in a serious title contention.
Okay, fantastic.
Position.
Tell me, thanks for that, Steve. Just in closing, I've seen... On your posters, you've got bigger and bigger names, right? That's what I did notice. You've got Conquest was on the bill.
Conquest is fighting on the 21st of March.
Okay. Now again, another. You seem to be fitting into that. You know, big names, biggish. Like we know they can fight. Just because you lose one or two fights, what is it matter?
Yeah, where our position is at the moment, and we're realistic, is Matchroom will pick up the fighters that are there. Mm. Warren will pick up some of the other ones, and we are then the next one down. We're picking them up, and a lot of fighters are coming to us who want their careers moved on. Mm. With people like Lee Mark, and we've got him an English title opportunity. Larry, we're moving on, and people are seeing that we're delivering. We've got a Commonwealth title for. So a lot of fighters are on the fringes and want that backing to get to the next level.
Ben mentioned you're looking at a TV of some variety. He didn't go into any detail.
Yeah, we're
pursuing it.
We're pursuing it. We're always pursuing it. I think we're getting towards it. And maybe in a year's time, we'll be ready for it. But we're looking at all different avenues. And we're building up in the meantime. I mean, I'm now in a situation where I manage over 65 boxers now.
And that's more horses than you ever had, right?
Absolutely. 22 horses was the most we ever had. But the good thing is, it's not just quantity, it's quality as well. The quality is there. We're signing some fantastic young prospects, people like Josh Kennedy, Lukman Patel, Jose Lopez.
Robert Asagba?
Well, he's not signed to us, so
he's
just fighting on our show.
He's fighting on our show, okay. Yeah. Oh, okay.
So these are people that are signed either managerially or promotionally.
Okay.
I mean, Robert's a great talent. He's on our show. Maybe we'll do some sort of deal with Ben Doherty going forward.
But and his advisor. And his exclusive
and
advisor.
But as things are, you know, the talent is coming through to us, and we're really looking forward to a massive 2015.
Okay, fantastic. Thanks so much for your time.
Pleasure.